Hello children, welcome to our world through English. So previously we discussed about Tenali paints horse, and next Dear Mom, a beautiful poem, and how you will behave naughtily at home during the time of your mother or father was not at home. So how you will behave, so we discussed in the previous poem, right? So today we have one more beautiful story, that is the Emperor's New Clothes. The Emperor's New Clothes. So what is the Emperor's new clothes? What is the secret behind the Emperor's new clothes? So what made a story very, very funny? So we are going to talk about the funny story. So I hope you will enjoy the story very much, and it is also available in YouTube. You can type the same title, The Emperor's New Clothes, a funny movie clip with video clip will be available, and you can watch that. So let me start today's class. Welcome to today's class. So many years ago, there was an emperor who was fond of new clothes. So fond of means interested. What is the meaning of fond of? Fond of means what? Interest. So fond of means what? Interest. So he was very, very interested of what? New clothes. So he was very, very fond of new clothes. Who is he? The emperor. That he spent all his money on them. So for that new clothes, he used to spend total money on them. Total money on them. So one day, two men came to emperor's court, weaver, and say, one day what happened? Two weavers means a person who will weave new clothes. So they came to our emperor and they were saying that we are weavers. They said, we can make the most beautiful cloth in the world. The emperor was very, very happy. So what they said, they came to K emperor and said that, my dear emperor, we are weavers. Who we are? Weavers. So weaver means what? The person who can weave clothes. Okay. One day happened, weavers came. So one day, two weavers came to emperor and said, emperor, we are the persons who can weave a finest cloth, a beautiful cloth, most beautiful cloth in the world for you. So if you give permission, if you give all the things, we can do this. Then immediately the emperor was very, very happy. The emperor was very, very happy. Why? Because he loves new clothes, and he was very, very fond of new clothes. What do you mean of fond of? Interest. So he was very, very interested about new clothes. So when the weavers said that we came to weave a beautiful, most beautiful cloth in the world, then immediately emperor was very, very happy. Oh, thank you very much. Then immediately what he was saying, our cloth is also very, very special. So then what the men were saying, our cloth is also very, very special. Said the men, what is the specialty of the cloth means? Only wise men can see it. What is that? Only wise men can see it. Fools cannot. So what he was saying, the speciality of our cloth is only wise people can see it. Only wise people can see it. Fools cannot. Means the dress what the emperor was wearing, only wise men can see the cloth. Fools cannot watch the dress. So that made emperor very, very interested. Why? Because he will come to know who is the wise man and who is the foolish man. So now, that's very good, thought emperor. When I wear the clothes made it, I will know who is the wise and who is foolish. Now emperor was thinking, you know, oh, thank you very much, my dear viewers, because you said a beautiful word. What the specialty of the cloth means? Only wise men can see it. Fools cannot. So when they said, emperor thought, oh wonderful, what a beautiful cloth, and what a beautiness, and what an interesting thing. Why? Because now if I wear the dress, then I will come to know that who is the wise man and who is the foolish people in my kingdom. Then emperor was very, very interested for the dress. Then the emperor gave a man a lot of money and start weaving at once, he told them. Then what happened? Immediately emperor said, okay, you can make the cloth. And he given a lot of money and said, start weaving the cloth. Then they set up two looms and pretended to be very, very busy, though they had nothing at all on the loom. So they had looms. You know looms? When you look at looms, for example, if you go to any weavers, they will have a loom. So they will revolve and they will move like this. So then it will move. So weavers, if you have seen Gandhi photo, Gandhi will with a weaver, a loom. Loom. So same thing here, they made two looms, two men, no? So two men had two looms and they pretended. Pretend means what? Acting. Pretend means what? Acting. So they pretended to be very, very busy. So they kept nothing on the looms, empty looms. So empty looms, they were saying that acting. They are having a big cloth on that. So like that, so they are doing like this, blue looms, and they were moving the cloth. So like that, they were acting. They were very, very busily acting that they are making a cloth. They asked for the finest silk and purest gold thread. They put these in their own bags and they worked at empty looms until late at night. So what happened? Same thing. They asked for finest cloth, finest silk and best gold thread. So they brought everything and whatever they got, they kept in the bag, in their own bags. And they started on working on the looms by keeping candles. During the night time, they kept candles. And in the night time, they were weaving, they were working on the looms. Then everybody was surprised, nothing was on the loom, but they are working very hardly, they were working. So there, the two men knows there was nothing there, but they were acting that they were weaving the cloth. So everybody was observing them. They were working till the nights. I should like to know how those weavers are getting on with my cloth, thought the emperor. So what happened? So one day, today completed, and the emperor was very eagerly waiting. What for the cloth? What is the specialty of the cloth? Only wise men can see it, fools cannot. So he was waiting for the cloth. When the day will complete, okay, I was eagerly waiting. I want to see the progress of the cloth, how much they completed, how much they made the dress. I want to know. Then immediately, only wise men can see the cloth. I will send my old minister, who is the wisest man in the court. So what happened? Immediately he wanted to see what is the progress of the cloth and what is the specialty of that. Only wise men can see that. So he thought, maybe if I send any common man, he can't find, because what is the specialty of the cloth? The specialty of the cloth is only wise men can see it. So what emperor thought, if I send any common man, he can't see it. So I have to send a wisest man in my kingdom. I have to send my wisest man. So immediately he called his old minister, who is the wisest man in his kingdom. He said, you just go there. So what he said, you know, so the good old minister went to the room in which the wise men were working at the empty looms. So what happened? He called the minister, my dear minister, you are the wisest man in my kingdom. So now the weavers were working, so only wise men can see the cloth. So you just go and see the progress, how much they completed, when it is going to be completed, how many days it will take to complete. You go and check the progress. progress. So now he went. When he went there, they were working on the empty looms. What they were doing? They were acting. Then the minister went to the weavers. What can be the meaning of this? Thought the old man, opening his wise eyes very wide. I can't see anything on the loom. So he went there. When he went there, the men were working. He is seriously working. And he went there and he was surprised like this. What is there? Nothing was there on the looms. I cannot see anything on the looms. Come a little nearest, said the men to the minister. Isn't the cloth beautiful? See what they were saying. When he was surprised, two men called, my dear minister, come here. See the cloth, how beautiful it is, how wonderful it is. Is it in the beautiful cloth? Then they pointed to the empty looms. The poor old minister looked hard. He couldn't see nothing on the looms, for nothing was there. But the two men called the minister. My dear old minister, see here, what a beautiful cloth it is. Isn't it beautiful? Then he came near. And what is there on the looms? Nothing was there. But what the two men were saying? They were weaving a beautiful cloth and asking, my dear minister, how beautiful cloth it is. How is it? Boy, is it okay? Then the minister found nothing on the looms. What he thought? Is it possible that am I a fool? Well, sir, said one of the men, how do you look? How do you like the cloth? Oh, it's splendid, said the minister. Then immediately what happened, you know? What happened? He was looking there. Then one of the men asked, tell me, sir, how is the cloth? If he says no, he is a fool, right? Because who will see the cloth? Only wise men can see the cloth. Only wise men can see the cloth. So if he says that I couldn't see the cloth, if he say that I couldn't see the cloth, who is he? He is a fool. So he said, oh, what a beautiful cloth. What he is saying? Is he saying truth or lie? He is saying the truth or lie? He is saying that, oh, what a beautiful cloth it is. How splendid it is. What a beautiful cloth I was seeing. Oh, what a wonderful cloth. Who is saying these dialogues? Minister. Why? Because if he say no, he is a fool. Then now the emperor thought he would like to see the cloth. So he called his officers and went with them to the weaver's room. Now what happened? So finally, emperor thought, I can't wait. I have to see the cloth. So he went to the weavers. So when he went there, then the men asking that, isn't the cloth beautiful, said the old minister, pointing to the empty loom. So now the old minister saying, my dear emperor, see the beautiful cloth on the looms. So how beautifully they were weaving. What is there on the looms? Empty. But when what the old minister was saying that, oh, what a beautiful cloth. If he won't say beautiful cloth, who is he now? A fool. Now he is saying that, oh, what a beautiful cloth it was. Then immediately that, how is this? Said the emperor to himself. I can see nothing at all. Am I a fool? Oh, it's beautiful, said the emperor aloud. Then what happened immediately? Then emperor thought that nothing was on the loom. If I say no, I will be the fool. Then immediately emperor said, oh, what a beautiful cloth you are making. This was really beautiful. Who is saying this? Loudly, emperor was saying that, oh, what a beautiful cloth. Old minister said that it was splendid. Now emperor was saying that, it's a beautiful cloth. Now everybody was surprised because nobody sees nothing there. But emperor said a beautiful cloth. Minister said a splendid cloth. Now see, all the officers looked keenly. They saw nothing on the looms, but they all said, it's very beautiful. Oh, the great portion next week, said the old minister, kindly wear the robes made of this cloth. Emperor agreed. So now what happened? All the officers looking, everybody, because if anyone says no, he will be the fool. Fools won't be in the kingdom of emperor. So everybody saying, oh, what a beautiful cloth. Nobody sees nothing Nobody sees anything on the looms, but everybody is saying that, oh, it was beautiful, it was wonderful, it was beautiful, it was wonderful. So everybody is saying that beautiful, wonderful, but they can't see anything on the looms. If anyone says nothing, they will be the fool. So even emperor said beautiful, minister said, officer said, and one more minister saying that, old minister, my dear emperor, next we have a big procession. So during that big festival, you can view the beautiful dress. The weavers work hard than ever, and last they said the cloth was ready. They cut in the air with a huge pair of scissors. They stitched the clothes with the needles without the thread in them. Now what happened, funniest thing, they took a scissors and said, okay, the cloth has been finished, we are stitching the dress. So they took big scissors and doing like this in the air. Nothing was there. Simply they are holding the cloth like this as a cloth, and simply they were cutting. They are cutting with the scissors, and everyone surprised. Maybe they are cutting the pieces, and they took a needle and they were stitching, and they kept nothing in the thread, because if they keep any thread, the thread will appear. So they kept nothing, and simply with the needle they were knitting this, and everybody surprised to see them, because they were very very busy in making that. They are acting like anything. So see, they. Next, the weavers work a lot, stitch the needle in. See, they cried at last, the emperor's new clothes are ready. So now they've given a cloth and said that, empty one. They said that, yes, these are the clothes of emperor. The clothes are ready. They said that. The emperor went to the weavers with his officers. The weavers raised their arms in the air and said, these are the trousers and this is the coat. Now what happened, they took empty hands and saying that, this is the coat, my dear emperor. And this is a trouser, now it is giving to the emperor. It was nothing there in hands, but everybody looking at each other, what is there. Then it is so light, and said them, and one of them, you won't even feel the clothes, said the other. So one man said that, one weaver saying that, it was too lightweight, my dear emperor. If you wear this one, you can't feel that is anything on my body. So it was very very beautiful to you, my dear emperor. Then that's the beauty of it, said one officer. Yes, said all the others, that's the beauty of it. But they couldn't see anything. There was nothing to see. But everybody, one officer saying that, oh, what a beautiful dress is, what a color was beautiful, the pair was beautiful, the coat was really good. Oh, my dear emperor, if you wear this dress, you will look like anything. And everybody praising the dress. But the reality is, nobody sees nothing there. So that was now going on there. So they couldn't see anything there. There was nothing to see. Will your majesty take off your clothes, said the man. So what happened? They said to remove the dress. So the emperor was going to remove his dress. Then you can put your new clothes. The emperor took off all his clothes. The men made a show of putting clothes on him. The emperor stood in front of a mirror and turned around. How well his majesty looks in his new clothes, cried all his officers. Now what happened, so the men said, my dear king, please remove your dress. So he removed the dress. Then they said, they wear the new dress. So there was nothing there. The emperor stand in front of a mirror and looking like this, oh, my shirt and my trouser, my clothes, and looking front and looking back. So there was nothing. Everybody crying that, oh, empress, your new clothes are very very beautiful. They were crying loudly and they were saying, your clothes were very very beautiful, emperor, new clothes were very very beautiful. So everybody saying that word, your clothes beautiful, your looks are very very beautiful. Then the emperor walked along in the procession. People in the street cried, how beautiful the emperor's new clothes are, how beautiful the emperor's new clothes are. So everybody started crying. What they're saying that, everybody clapping, but they are crying, emperor, new clothes are very very beautiful. Because all they come to know that, who will see the clothes? Only wise men can see the close, so they can't see anything there. So they thought they were the fools. So everybody crying that Emperor's new clothes are very, very beautiful. Emperor's new clothes are very, very beautiful. Everybody crying in the procession. Means a big festival was going on at the time. But he's got nothing at all, said the little boy. Now what happened? The small child saying that, but he's got nothing on at all. Small boy doesn't know anything, no? The small boy saying that he's having nothing on his body. And one person said to another, he has nothing on at all. He has nothing on. He has nothing on. Cried all the people. The emperor felt unhappy. He knew that the people were right. He had nothing, but the procession had to go on. So finally what happened, you know, the emperor had nothing on his body. When the small boy said he had nothing on his body, everybody saying that he has nothing. So everybody come to know that the men made the king as a fool. Yes or no? So the procession went on without any dress. You can see in the textbook. If you're not having textbook, please look at here the screen. So the emperor moving without anything on his body. So the story was going on like this. So all the people made, finally the king became fool. The king became a fool. Why? Because that people made, the young man who came to weave the dress, they made our king as a fool. So that is the end of the story. The emperor's new clothes. So let me explain the story again and ask you some questions. That, let me see here, the emperor's new clothes. So the emperor was very, very fond of, what the meaning of fond of means, interested about new clothes. So one day two men came and they said, we are the weavers. What they said, we are the weavers. So what they said, the speciality of the dress is only wise men can see it, fools cannot. And they said, my dear king, there is a speciality for our dress. And what is the speciality of our dress means, only wise men can see the dress. Who can see the dress? Only wise men can see the dress. Fools cannot find the dress. Who cannot see the dress? Fools cannot see the dress. Then immediately emperor was very, very happy. Why? Because maybe this was very, very specialty. Maybe this was very, very special, because only wise men can see means fools cannot see means, now I will come to know that in my kingdom, who is the wise man in my kingdom, who is the fool. So I will come to know who is the real king, who is the fool, who is the wise man, who is the fool in my kingdom. So now emperor was eagerly waiting to get the cloth. Then immediately he said to the weavers, okay, my dear young men, you go. And he given a lot of money for them. So they went to their room and they started weaving on the empty looms. There were looms on the working on the looms, and it was very, very empty. When it was very, very empty, all they were even acting. They were pretended. For example, in the classroom, when we are listening any class, what you will do in the classroom? You will sit in the classroom like this. And what you will do? You will act like this. You will hold and you will keep your hands and you look at the board like this. But you won't listen the class. Simply you will act. The same thing here, this young man who came to weave the dress of cloth of emperors, they came to act. They started acting. They took two looms and they started acting that they was working on something. So it was empty loom. They were working. But is there anything on there? Nothing was there. So they were empty looms. They were working on a empty looms, working. One day emperor got surprised. I want to see my clothes. How they were working during the night times also, by keeping lamps, candles, they were working. One day emperor got, I want to see my beautiful clothes. So he wanted to send a man. And what he want to send? If I send a common man, what he will do? Will he see the cloth? No. Who can see the cloth? Only wise man can see the cloth. So I have to send a wisest man in my kingdom. So he called old minister, who is very, very wisest man. So he said, my dear minister, you just go and see the cloth. What is the progress of my dress? Then immediately he went. When he went there, the two men were working like anything on the empty looms. Working on the empty looms. They were acting that they were doing anything. So when he went there, he was surprised. He was like this, widened his eyes. Nothing was there. They were acting, they were weaving, but I couldn't find anything. Am I a fool? Because I am not finding the cloth means I will be a fool. If I say no, all they will feel that I am a fool. Then immediately he went near to the man. They said, my dear minister, look at the cloth. How beautifully it was there. The color was beautiful and the cloth was very, very nice. So how you are enjoying the cloth? Isn't it good? Isn't it beautiful? Then the minister was in dilemma. If he says no, he will be the fool. And is he finding anything there? He was finding nothing. So immediately he said, oh, what a splendid cloth it was. What a beautiful cloth it was. Then immediately he said, okay, it was very, very beautiful. Then he went to emperor and he said, oh, my dear emperor, they were working day and night. Day and night they are working for your cloth, your dress, my dear emperor. And the cloth was very, very beautiful. And if you see that, really you will enjoy that. Then emperor got very, very enthusiastic. I have to see my dress. Then immediately he said, come, we will go and we will see. So emperor went there. When emperor went there, the young men were working. And he saw that nothing was on the loom. Nothing was on the looms. But the men said, my dear emperor, see the cloth. How the cloths were. It is going to finish. It is going to finish. Emperor was surprised and looked at all. All they were looking at that. Emperor said, oh, if he say no, he will be the fool. Then emperor immediately said, oh, what a beautiful cloth it is. What a beautiful cloth it is. I was really happy, my dear viewers. Thank you very much. He was saying that. Immediately all the officers saying that, yeah, beautiful cloth it is. What a beautiful cloth. Because emperor only said the beautiful. If they says no, they will be the fools. So immediately he said, oh, beautiful, 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 beautiful. Everybody saying that it was very, very beautiful. It was very, very beautiful. Then immediately the man has said that it has been completed. It has been completed. They took a big scissors and they started cutting. They started cutting that in the air. Where they were cutting? In air only they were cutting. In air they were cutting. After that they said they took a needle, big needle, and they didn't kept any thread in it. Simply emptily they were knitting. And after that they said, okay, my dear emperor, the dress has been finished. The dress has been finished. After that emperor was surprised and they said, might they given to emperor with empty hands, and they said, here, this is the trouser, my dear emperor. And one man came and he said, this is your coat. And they couldn't find anything there. And when they're giving like this, and they said, oh, my dear emperor, if you wear this one, you will feel that nothing was on your body. Nothing was in your body. They said, okay. Then they said to remove the dress. Emperor removed the dress. Then they said that to wear the dress. Then they kept the coat, the trouser, and they went by taking the biggest gold and money and finest silk. They went. Then immediately the procession has been started. A big festival was going on the road. And all the men were saying that, oh, how beautiful the king dress, how beautiful the new emperor's new clothes, how beautiful emperor's new clothes. Everybody crying. But they couldn't find anything on the body of emperor. So everybody crying that emperor's new clothes were very beautiful. Emperor's new clothes were very, very beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Everybody crying. But a small boy was on the road and he has seen that, yeah, emperor's new clothes were very beautiful. He couldn't find anything. He couldn't wear anything. Then everybody saying that, yes, he had nothing on his body. He has nothing on his body. He has nothing on his body. So everybody saying that he has nothing on his body. Nothing on his body. Everybody started saying the word. Then emperor came to know that the men taught him a lesson. So the story has been ended with the insult of the emperor. So my dear children, the question is for you, who is the wise man here? Either the emperor or the viewers. Who is a wise man here? Yes, the weavers are very, very wise. For that only, they fool even the kingdom and emperor and everybody. So that is the end of the story. The emperor's new clothes. So I hope that you enjoyed the class, right? So thank you for watching, children, and meet you in the next class. Until then, stay home and stay safe. Until then, bye bye. Take care.